Welcome to the Beyond Cinema and Bio.com studio up here at TIFF. Gabe Polsky, feature directorial debut. Obviously, it's been kind of on the road this year, starting off with a pretty amazing place in Cannes. What did that mean to you, kind of having been kind of being able to take that journey and to somewhere so significant?
I mean, I never expected to get into Cannes. I mean, to me, it was just kind of like a pipe dream, to be honest. And you know, when I got the call or the email, I was just in shock. And, you know, first of all, it's a documentary, and they take very few documentaries, so that was also special. And then, yeah, I mean, I couldn't believe it. And then the fact that, you know, the story is about the Soviet Union and it has elements of sports in it, again, are things that kind of hold the film back. So that, again, I was even more surprised that they wanted it. But the director of the festival, Thierry Fermeau, was extremely positive and excited about this film and was really looking forward to having it. And the response there was incredible. People, you know, in France, they don't really like, they don't know anything about hockey, and they're sports fans. They people would come up to me saying, "Yeah, I don't know anything about hockey, but I love it now." And it was really fun to see that, and it just confirmed that the movie is not about hockey per se, or sports, or politics, or history. It's really kind of about human soul and spirit, and the soul of a country.
So, do you think that that's a reflection of the fact that you had passion for the subject matter, and kind of poured that into it, and hoped it came out the other side?
Yeah, I mean, I think when a filmmaker has passion about anything, that you can kind of feel it through the screen. And this is something I had a lot of passion about growing up, and like I said before, it's just really important to me especially that I wasn't making this film for hockey fans. You know, just I was making it for everybody, for people who like good stories and good filmmaking and films that have a soul. You know, that was just really critical for me.
For you, what was the kind of best discovery you made about a subject that maybe you thought you knew?
Yeah, that's a good question. Yeah, I mean, I set out to make a film about that. I wanted to parallel this great team and this great sports dynasty with the rise and fall of the Soviet Union. But it's amazing how closely the parallel was between the lives of the players and the lives of everybody in the Soviet Union. It seems like everybody kind of went through a similar experience one way or another, and I felt that was really interesting. And then getting to know the details of the players' stories and what they went through and how they lived and what the sacrifices they had to make, you know, was revealing to me as well, because I didn't know the details. I knew, you know, a very general part of the story, but then when you're making a film, you start to learn every little detail and how emotional these guys are. And that was really interesting.
In terms of directing narrative versus directing docs, are you now more addicted to one process than the other?
No, I like directing both narrative and feature and documentaries. I think documentaries are way more editorially intensive and grueling, and they feel like they're never ending in the editing process. So you have to really roll your sleeves up and kind of know what you're getting into, and since this is my first documentary, I didn't know how difficult it was going to be in the editorial process, but I realized that, you know, to really think twice before, you know, engaging in the next project, you know, you got to really have that passion to get you through the many ups and downs and the amount of time that it takes and all that. And I'm still interested in it, but it has to be something that I'm just incredibly passionate about to help drive you through. And I think the same is for features, because you're really finding the story in the editing room during documentaries, and that can just be mentally draining and and challenging.
Yeah, and now obviously bringing it to Canada, they know a little bit more about hockey than France, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Less of a learning curve.
Exactly, and I also brought it, the film premiered also in Moscow. It was the opening film of the festival. So they, you know, in Russia, they also are familiar with hockey, especially the Soviet Union, the national team. That was, I was really worried about that, just because, you know, here an American was coming to show a film about the Soviet Union, about Russia. Like, you know, they're probably thinking, well, why is an American coming here to tell our story? You know, it's strange, but afterwards, people embraced the film. There were people crying and coming up to me saying, you know, really appreciative that I told this story. And maybe it took somebody with a little bit of distance from that to kind of have...
Did you get any of the other? Did you get any of the kind of more derogatory, any negative feedback there?
In Russia, I didn't get any, really any negative feedback. The critics... pretty unanimously like the project. In Canada, what I'm concerned about a little bit is that, you know, people will focus too much on the hockey and sort of making sure that, you know, why wasn't Canada sort of included in this rivalry more? And, you know, they're going to be, I feel like that could be a possibility, but... Yeah, I mean, again, it's not really a film about hockey per se. It's about so much more. Yeah. But I'm so excited to share it with Canadians. I mean, you know, because I know that they respect the game and that's what a lot of them live for. And, you know, and there's not that many movies that kind of have hockey in them. And I hope that they, you know, recognize sort of, or, you know, appreciate sort of the
so you're talking about how difficult it is to kind of have the almost reverse of the narrative where you put the work into the script, then you shoot it, and then the editing kind of has at least a template, you know. For this one, in terms of finding that story, you've obviously got a pretty good network, having worked as a producer on a lot of cool projects that have a lot of, you know, well-known people in them, and even the film about Jerry Weintraub and all that sort of stuff. So do you turn to those people and ask them for advice? Like, do you go to, is there a mentor or a couple of mentor figures that kind of coach you through it?
I think that, you know, both Jerry Weintraub and Werner Herzog have taught me a lot about the film business and about life, but it's not like they come to you or you go to them and they sit you down and say, okay, Gabe, this is what you have to do, this is how you fix this, this is how you do this. It's not like that. It's more about observing how they behave, how they approach their work, all those things. It's more about observing and then using that to kind of inspire you. And sort of these guys have been through tremendous amount of ups and downs, you know, and I think as a filmmaker, it's just about getting through these ups and downs and sort of having, realizing that I'm not the first guy that's sort of been through this, and look at all these other people that have struggled to make projects that seem kind of unmakeable, you know, get through to the end, you know, and that's inspiring to know that they've done it countless times, and sometimes it's depressing because you feel...
Well, I mean,
like, why can't I do this?
Werner is kind of famous for being, you know, for doing, having extreme ups and downs, some of them visually represented.
Yeah, I mean, Werner Herzog, you know, just over and over again is able to get these very challenging films made, and he, you know, he doesn't sit there and complain. He figures out how to do it, and he goes and he does it, you know, and I think that's a big lesson, you know.
Growing up you grew up in Chicago?
Yeah.
Did you grow up in isolation of the entertainment business, or did you have it accessible to you
then? Yeah, I knew nothing about the entertainment business growing up, and it wasn't until, like, at the end of my college life where I started to sort of even look into it. You know, I didn't know anything, nothing.
And what was the prompt then? What was the spark?
I had a roommate that was in college that was very creative and was doing improv and writing and stuff like that, and I thought that was really interesting, and, you know, I felt that I could, you know, that I had some of that within me, and that I that the profession, that the film business could be something that I could do pretty well, telling stories and just having the wherewithal to put everything together and tell an interesting story. I felt that I could do a good job, and I just tried to learn as much as I could.
So for a young filmmaker who is not in LA or New York, or someone who wants to pursue that, what was kind of your first step, or what would you now think of as being the best first step?
I think that learning as much as you can about the business, about what it is you want to do, knowing yourself very well, and then just finding a way to go after it. There's so many different routes to success that you just have to have faith in yourself and make smart decisions and, you know, keep working towards that and take risks, you know, because if you don't take risks, you're not gonna make it happen.
And a final question that we like, obviously, in terms of anyone on the planet who you could work with, alive or dead, like, who is that person that would just be either the greatest collaborator or the greatest person to observe?
I'm going to kind of cop out on this answer because I just, there's a lot of talented people. I just love, and everyone does, I mean, just people who are good at what they do, and they just kind of, they somehow, whether it's an actor or a director or whatever, they somehow are able to get things onto the screen that you can't even really describe why they're so good, but it's just, they just got it, you know, and I like, I don't know how it happens, it's like magic, but it takes a lot of work, but at the same time, just people who can kind of get to that magic, get to the soul of things, you know, the truth, even if it's humorous, you know.
Via, like seemingly effortlessly, or you can see the amount of dedication?
Yeah, but I think anything that's done really well takes a tremendous amount of work, but it comes out naturally because I don't know, that's what talent is. It's sort of hard work that looks effortlessly, but it's taken a while to kind of get that.
And so what's next, back to narrative, or...?
Yeah, I'm not 100% sure. I don't have my next project yet, but I've got things ready and I've written some things and, you know, and just we'll see what happens.
And working with your brother again as well?
No, I'm going to direct my own things and, you know.
Cool. Just different creatives? Different creative spirit?
Yeah, I mean, directing with two people is very, very difficult, very difficult. And I just, you know, I would like to do it on my own, I think, you know.
Very cool. All right, well, thanks for coming in. Appreciate it.
Thank you very much. Yeah.